Thank you very much for your attendance today. Earlier, we had our executive session. No vote was taken and no items to be voted on following executive session. It will take just one moment to pass on the agenda, but to invite an individual to introduce himself to us. It's John Loomis. He's up in Carolina, he's president, and he's on his way to another county today. And I asked him to stop by and introduce himself to us. So, John?
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. Appreciate the opportunity to come today. Thank you for the invitation. My name is John Loomis, and I am the new president of the Upstate Alliance. Started about 6 weeks ago, so I'm kind of learning my way, but I did want to have the opportunity to come over and meet the county council here. Appreciate everything y'all do. I work very closely with Carter Smith on a daily, weekly basis, and have known him for a long time. And I feel very strongly about Spartanburg and all the great things that y'all have going on. Y'all have obviously had an incredible and record-setting year already this year, which is fantastic, and I know that that's going to move forward. But my background, just real quickly, I was at Tri-County Technical College for 8 years, working in economic development, workforce development, and worked in as the director of the foundation there. And previous to that, I was at Anderson County as the economic development director, and was there for 4 years. I live in Anderson, grew up there, so I'll be commuting from Anderson to Greenville to work every day, and I just look forward to being with you. I was in leadership South Carolina with Michael Brown, so it's good to see you again, Michael. Thank you, sir. And I've had the opportunity to meet with Mr. Britt and Mr. Horton, and I look forward to meeting all of y'all on an individual basis. But it's going to be a pleasure to work with Spartanburg, and just thank you for the opportunity. Y'all have anything y'all want to ask me today?
Have a safe trip.
Okay. Thank you so much, Chairman. I appreciate the opportunity to come today. Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Next, we'll move to our board appointments. First is the Airport Environment Planning Commission. We have an individual who did not wish to be reappointed, but we have a by-owner, John Dobson.
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to waive the rules and nominate John Dobson.
Motion, do we have a second?
Second.
Second from John Dobson. Now, any discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? Affirmative? It passes. They find someone for Board of Appeals, correct, David? Do they need to be in School District 3 or not? Just in real estate?
Finance.
Okay. Either District 3 and someone in finance and in real estate. Chisney Community, Fire District.
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to waive the rules, nominate elect William Donald Mason.
Have William Donald Mason. Sorry. And a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? All affirmative, it passes. Domestic violence board.
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to waive the rules, nominate the elect 50 L. Lenoir.
Okay. 50.
She's the vacant at large position.
Oh, okay. All right, we have a Vicky. We have a second. David, you second.
Second. All right.
Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? All affirmative? It passes.
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to waive the rules and nominate elect Doris Boozer.
Have a motion and a second on Doris Boozer. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. Opposed, affirmative,
and
it passes.
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to waive the rules and nominate the elect Jennifer O'Shields.
Second.
I have a motion and a second on Jennifer O'Shields. Do we have any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, affirmative, and it passes. Anyone else? All right, looks like we need to carry over Interreed, Hobbitsville, 2 month community action. We have Spartanburg Memorial Auditorium.
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to waive the rules and nominate the elect J.P. Bader.
We have a have a motion, I mean, JP Mayor, we have a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, or vote affirmative, JP passes. Order to advisory committee.
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to waive the rules and nominate Mr. William A. Blackwood III.
I have a motion on William A. Blackwood, and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. Opposed, vote affirmative, JP passes.
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to waive the rules and nominate Mr. Thomas E. Watson from Wilson.
I have a motion and a second on Thomas Watson. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, vote affirmative, JP passes. Thank you very much. Item four, city information takes desired action in reference to an ordinance amending ordinance 296, modified in 2-206, as to remove the authorization of council requirement to transfer property to the forfeited land commission. Ms. Catherine, if you would just fill us in briefly again.
Sure, Mr. Chairman, there was an ordinance, this ordinance number 296, it was passed a number of years ago by county council to try to help facilitate the process of the transfer of property from delinquent tax to the FLC. There were some concerns about, at the time, about making sure that county council had an opportunity to review the properties to help the FLC not receive properties that may not be interested in receiving. There's a state statute that was passed after county council's ordinance that does protect the FLC and give them those options to reject a sale from the delinquent tax sale. So at this point, what we're asking you to do is to remove the authorization of county council from the process. What it's turned into is really a delay in trying to facilitate the transfer of property from the FLC to a bidder. Depending on your schedule, it could be a 45-day delay, and we sure would like to take that out of the process. If someone's truly interested in buying property from the FLC, we want to help facilitate that very quickly. So if council is okay with that direction, we would ask that you then your first reading to this ordinance.
You've heard the explanation again. We have a motion.
So moved.
We have a motion.
Second.
Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, vote affirmative, JP passes. Thank you much. Now we move to our committee meetings. The first is Economic Recruitment and Development. Honorable David Britt, Chairman. Michael Brown, Roger Nutt, member. Mr. Britt.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. We have two items before the committee today. First item, we have a request to hear first reading to an ordinance to amend an existing agreement for the development of the joint county industrial business park by between Spartanburg County and Union County, South Carolina, so as to enlarge the boundaries of the park to include certain properties located in Spartanburg presently owned and or operated by Michelin North America, Inc. Do I hear a move that will be approved on first reading?
So moved.
Second. Motion been made and second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carries and we'll recommend it for council at 5:30. Second item, we have a request to render first reading to an ordinance to amend the agreement for development for a joint county industrial park by and between Spartanburg County and Cherokee County, South Carolina, so as to include additional property in Spartanburg County as part of the joint county industrial park. We're here. Motion to approve on first reading.
So moved.
Second. Motion made and second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Motion carries. We'll recommend that to full council. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. That concludes our committee meeting.
Thank you, Mr. Britt. So item is under public health today. Under personnel and finance, we have Honorable Bill Covert, Chairman, Jeff Horton, Jane Hall, members. Mr. Covert.
Yes, sir, Mr. Chairman. We have several items coming before our committee today. The first is to receive information and take desired action in reference to accommodations tax advisory committee recommendations for the fiscal year 2015. Mr. Gerald Pulserek is the accommodations tax advisory committee member to present. And I apologize. That's your name, brother.
Kasaric.
Okay. Apologize.
Good afternoon. I think you have a copy of this in front of you. So we met with everyone in April and listened to their requests on receiving some of the tax accommodation funding. We met a week later after that, and we came up with our recommendations that are in front of you. So I guess if you have any questions, I'll be happy to answer them for you.
Yes, sir.
Can we get something that shows the amount that we did last year as well?
I too would appreciate that. And quite frankly, I'd like to make a motion to hold this over until next month's meeting. There were some questions that I'd like to have answered on this, such as funding to certain groups and the funding, non-funding to others. So, Mr. Chairman, I make a motion that we hold this over to next month.
I want to pose a question to your staff. This needs to be in the, I think, in the budget process.
We'll need to make sure that the accommodations tax budget is finalized by your third reading of the budget.
We can do this, it's perfect. I have a motion to table this to next month, I have a second. I have a motion, a second, all those in favor, raise your hand, raise your right hand. We're going to study it a little bit.
Okay.
Thank you.
And we'll ask you some questions next month.
Sure.
Next item on our agenda is receive information, take desired action in reference to a budget ordinance relating to the fiscal affairs of Spartanburg County, making appropriations, therefore levying taxes for the fiscal year beginning July 1st, 2014, and ending June 30th, 2015. Provided for the budget control of the said appropriation by the Spartanburg County Council. Ms. Captain O'Neill, our administrator, is going to talk about this.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I did want to make one note on your way into this discussion about an oversight in the packet that was sent to you at the last meeting. We had last year's travel policy in the budget ordinance. You adopted a different, a previous travel policy, not last year's travel policy you adopted. So we have now updated your budget ordinance language with regard to travel to what you had approved last year, and that has to do with following the GSA schedule for per diem. So that has been hot. If you had seen that, I want to make sure that you knew why we had made that change. So this is actually what you have approved last year. We have two motions that I was hoping that council would consider. One has to do with the Emergency Services Academy. And this will be a corresponding amendment on your next item on the agenda, Mr. Chairman. What I'm asking is that you increase the appropriations to the Emergency Services Academy by $35,000. This is going to represent the amount of money that was set aside in your capital improvement plan. I'd like to move it to operating expenses to work on a project that the fire services and the fire service advisory committee and I are working on to make some improvements to the burning building. So if you'll help me with that motion, that would increase the ESA budget by $35,000. It doesn't change the total allocations because the CIP at your next item will go down. And then in SADAC, I wanted to ask for your help with two things. They've received a grant since the last time we met, and they're picking up a full-time person. It'd be increasing by one position. It's a less than a full-time FTE related to the grant. And then they have some revenue and expenditure appropriations that have to do with personnel expenses that they are asking that we go ahead and take care of here at second reading. So those would be the two amendments that I know that are needed to the budget. I'd be glad to entertain any amendment questions that council may have or any other changes that you would be interested in talking about in the budget.
Any questions before we proceed? All right, the first one, I would like to entertain a motion for the committee to recommend the full council to amend part one of the budget ordinance operations for county government, section 8, appropriations as follows. Amend the general fund expenditures by increasing the appropriation of the emergency services cabinet by $35,000, bringing the total to $227,021, and increasing the appropriation transfers for the funds department by $35,000 to $15,502,609. Can I entertain a motion?
I make a motion.
A second. Any discussion? All those in favor, let it be known by raising the right hand. So it carries. Next, I'd like to entertain a motion for the committee to recommend the full council to amend part one of the budget ordinance operation for county government section 8 appropriations related to the alcohol and drug abuse, SADAC, to increase the fund balance of alcohol, drug abuse revenue line items, and to increase the following departments: community referral, prevention, drug court by the amount shown in the table below, and to increase the authorized staffing by one staff, 0.67 FDH for a part-time position related to a new grant and change the total alcohol drug abuse fund revenue and expedition appropriation to $3,110,085. Total revenue expenditure appropriation for all funds will change to $177,438,496. Now entertain a motion.
Motion.
Second motion. Have a second. Any discussion? All those let me know by raising the favor, let me know by raising the right hand. So carries.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Are there any other amendments to the budget that your committee would like to consider?
All right, next item is receive and take desired action in a reference to a budget ordinance to establish capital projects, capital project budgets for the year 2014 through 15, budget year of the 5-year capital improvement plan. Captain, some more questions?
Mr. Chairman, I think we will still need second reading, the recommendation for second reading of the budget ordinance for item E. And then you have your amendments that you just made that.
But you want the third amendment on this?
Well, we'll need for item B, you've made the amendments. Now we'll need a vote on the amended budget for second reading.
I'm so sorry. I'm getting a little overwhelmed. All right. All right, on this other one, we need to, do I entertain a motion that we render second reading to the ordinance?
To the amended, as amended.
As amended.
I make that motion.
Yeah, and also.
Mr. Chairman, we have two motions to make a recommendation to full council. At this point, the budget has not been amended. I think what we're trying to do is just get the budget out for second reading.
Now we're on item B, which will get it out of committee to second reading, correct?
Correct.
And Catherine, is this where we need to discuss after our last meeting that Senate had lowered the local government fund, then they voted a little bit back last week. And should we talk about that now?
Sure.
Here, after our last meeting, you may have read that the Senate had also voted to reduce the local government fund some additional money. And that was going to affect Spartanburg County to the tune of, what, $825,000, Jim? $825,000. And then last week, they had made an amendment and got a little bit over $600,000 that we're in a deficit from last year's recommended funding. But we've been assured by some of our senators that by the end of this process, that this money should be back in the budget. So as we move forward today with the second reading, we are cognizant of the fact that they have voted so far, and if they do not reinstate the money by the time we pass third reading, then we've got to come up with an additional
It's almost 700 grand,
but we've been assured by some of our senators that this is just the way things work in Columbia. And that our funding from the level that it was last year should be in the state budget by the time the budget is passed. So that being said, I voted to give the second reading in committee, cognizant that you know that we're aware that the funding so far is not approved by the state, but should be approved by the state. If not, by third reading, we have some bills with you.
We have a motion and a second. Any discussion? All those in favor, let me know by raising the right hand. And we'll refer to full council or a 5 o'clock meeting. Right now, item C. Receive information and take desired action in reference to a budget ordinance to establish capital project budgets for the year 2014 through 2015, budget year of the 5-year capital improvement plan. Ms. Catherine O'Neill, present.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. As I mentioned on item B, there's a corresponding motion that would be needed here for the CIP for our capital budget ordinance that would decrease the transfer from the general fund by $35,000 and decrease the public safety appropriation by the same amount because you just picked it up in the general fund budget. And that's the only change that the staff would need to do from your workshop.
All Okay, now I need to entertain a motion for the committee to recommend to full council to amend Part One, Section One of the capital budget ordinance for fiscal year 2014 to 2015 as related to the general fund transfer, public safety project expenditures. This amendment will decrease the amount within the general fund by $35,000, from $435,000 to $400,000, and decrease the public safety appropriation by $35,000, from $2,056,371 to $2,021,371, and thereby decreasing the total capital budget from $19,149,620 to $19,114,620. Can I entertain a motion to do so?
I make that motion.
Second.
Have a motion and a second, any discussion? Those in favor, let me know by raising your right hand. So you move. So carries.
So, Mr. Chairman, this is...
All right, now we're going to go back, and now can we entertain a motion that we render second reading to the ordinance?
To recommend second reading.
With the budget, with the recommendations.
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to make a motion that we render second reading to the ordinance for the CIP for 2014-15.
Clear the motions. All those in favor, are there any questions? Any questions, all those in favor, let me know by raising your right hand. So carries.
And, Mr. Chairman, I think what we were looking for there was, just make sure that I understood your motion, is that the committee is recommending to full council the second reading of this ordinance later on this evening, and it has this one amendment for a reduction of $35,000.
Would you like for us to restate that?
Probably just to make sure that you don't have any problems with this motion. If you could restate your motion, which would be that you're recommending to full council the CIP budget as it was amended here in your committee.
Mr. Chairman, I make a motion, you want me to make a motion?
Yeah.
That we recommend the full council of CIP as amended with the two numerical evaluations for public safety and for... Just public safety on this one.
I thought we did that, but I'll second it.
Okay, we hope we've worded that correctly.
Does that sound good this time?
I think we're set, you guys are making your recommendation for second reading.
Yeah, I thought we did.
Presented to full council.
With the amendments.
With the amendments. We have a motion and a second, any questions, Doug? All those in favor, let me know by raising your right hand. So carries. We good?
We're good.
Okay. Item D, receive information to take desired action in reference to a resolution of historic designation for a special tax assessment under Section 70-169 of the Spartanburg County South Carolina Code of Ordinances for that certain parcel of approved real estate known as Appalach Mill. Mr. Chris Rogers is going to present.
Good afternoon. I'm Chris Rogers, and unfortunately, the principal of the entity that owns this mill, Mr. Dale Goodrich, was not able to be here due to a prior commitment today, and I would like to apologize on his behalf that he couldn't be here. But the reason we're asking for this resolution, I think Mr. Colbert is somewhat familiar, and the rest of you may be, with this mill, it's the Appalachian Mill, which is over 100 years old, built around the turn of the century. And a predecessor mill on the same site was actually built in 1838, so the history here is very rich. And unfortunately, the site cannot be placed on the National Register of Historic Places with the National Park Service because certain structures on the site have been torn down, but the main mill building is still there, and Mr. Goodrich wants to make every effort to preserve that. And we are working with county staff to try to find a way to do that. When Mr. Goodrich originally purchased this property, he had the hopes of rehabilitating the mill with historic tax credits, which would have, these incentives make it more affordable and feasible to do these types of projects. Unfortunately, since it can't be placed on the National Register, he can no longer get tax credits, at least some of them. And so he's having a hard time making the rehab feasible. So he's having to take another look at how he's going to do this project. And so what we're asking at this point, what we're asking council to do is just approve there's a tax abatement that attaches to historic properties that's available for historic properties, which I'm sure you all are aware of. It's generally referred to as the Bailey Bill. It freezes the assessed value for a period of years at the pre-rehabilitated value so that it makes it more affordable to do the project. In this case, Mr. Goodrich is now looking for other partners to help him, more equity partners to help him change the project a little bit, bring some more equity into the project so that he can get it done. In order for him to do that, make it reasonable, he needs to know that it is at least feasible for him to get the Bailey Bill tax abatement on this property. And in order for him to do that, the county has to designate it as a historic property, a historic site. And so that's what we're here asking for. We're not asking for the actual abatement. We're just asking for the designation that would make it eligible for the abatement. So we would come back later on once we have our plans revised and ready to go. We'll continue to work with staff on that. And when we have it all ready to go, we'll come back and ask for the actual tax abatement. But this time, we're just asking that the council designate this site, the Appalachian Mill, as a historic site that would be eligible if the county deems it appropriate in the future to give it the tax abatement.
Does anyone have any questions, Mr. Rogers? Can I entertain a motion that we adopt the resolution?
Second.
Motion and a second. Any questions? There are no further questions at this time. All those in favor, let it be known by the raising of the right hand. We will take it over to full council.
Thank you.
Mr. Chairman, that's all we have. We have our updated financial data, but we all have that in our report.
Thank you, Mr.
Cobbler.
Mr. Chairman, may I ask a favor for Mr. Rogers? If there's no additional questions that the rest of council may have about this particular item, can he be excused from the meeting?
Do you have any questions they'd like to ask?
Does anyone have any questions for Mr. Rogers later on, or does anyone have a problem with Appalachia which we discussed? If not, Mr. Rogers, I don't see any opposition, so you're free to go home if you like, go back to work.
Thank you.
Next, we have Livability Committee, Honorable James Hall, Chairman, David Britt, Michael Brown, member. Ms. Hall?
Yes, Mr. Chairman, we're going to receive information in reference to the Tame the Tiger race that took place this spring. And Ms. Elizabeth Hardy, Recreation Programs Assistant Manager, and Ben Palmer with the Recreation Coordinator, Spartanburg Parks, is here to present.
Good afternoon. First, I would like to thank you, council members, and Ms. O'Neill for the opportunity to come before you and share some exciting opportunities that our Outdoor Recreation Department, as well as the Parks Department, has been involved in. First of all, I would just like to say that outdoor recreation is quickly being recognized as one of the fastest growing and most sustainable means of tourism, which supports our Spartanburg County Tourism Action Plan. There have been several unique opportunities that the Parks Department has either put on ourselves or in partnership with other community partners that has brought in people from all over, not only South Carolina, North Carolina, Georgia, Pennsylvania, and one as far as Vermont. We are going to first reference Tame the Tiger, and I'll let Ben give you some specific information on that. That was his baby to bring to fruition, and we've been really excited with his results.
This was the 15th year that Tame the Tiger actually occurred. For those who don't know, this is a 7.5 mile downriver race on the Tiger River. Starts at Morris Bridge Road in Roebuck and ends Old Hillsbridge Road down in Pauline. The winning racer's time this year was 1 hour and 9 minutes, which is pretty quick to cover that 7.5 mile period distance. We had 148 people attend the River Race Ending Festival. Food was provided by Carolina Barbecue. Music was provided by Grayson Turner and the Thrift Store Rejects. We had 96 registrants, 11 safety boaters, and 10 assistants via Spartanburg EMS Swiftwater Rescue Team. We had assorted sponsors, namely the Tiger River Foundation, StarTex Jackson Water District, Woodruff Roebuck Water District, and the Lindell Health Leadership School, with who, without their sponsorship, we would not have been able to have the race because they volunteered a lot of people to help out. On top of that, we had Green River Adventures, the Gorge Zip Line, Thai Taste Restaurant, Piranha Kayaks, Climb Up State Rock Climbing Gym, Sea to Summit Dry Bags, and Custom Awnings as sponsors as well.
So you're all familiar with the statement, it takes a village to raise a child. Well, in outdoor recreation, it takes a village of partnerships to make an event successful. So with partnership with these agencies and sponsors that Ben mentioned, Tame the Tiger was very successful. And I'd like to point out that it was also on a day that was in competition with several other outdoor recreation types of events, namely a paddling festival. So the turnout was actually better than anticipated, knowing that we were competing with some other very big paddling events. I'd also like to mention that Paddle the Packlet happened on April 26th. They did their soft launch and it was very well attended with 26 participants. This was also in partnership with the town of Packlet, Packlet Milliken, and our department. On the same day, we were having to divide and conquer. We did Discover Your Watershed. This took place as well on April 26th and was also a very successful event that not only allowed participants to try stand-up paddleboarding and kayaking, but also educated participants about the watershed, our local watersheds and conservation efforts that are being made. Last, before we show the video, which is far more exciting than our presentation, I would like to say thank you all very much for trusting the research that I put forward about this time last year about stand-up paddleboarding, and I'm very pleased to see that the research has proven true in that all of our classes in May have not only made in terms of every slot filled, but we've also been on the waiting list, and we're really excited to be able to report that to you all. And with that being said, Ben is going to tell you about some upcoming events, and then we'll show you the really exciting portion.
One question real quick.
Yes, ma'am.
How many participants were at the Paddle Packet?
Paddle the Packet, I believe we had 56 participants that were in attendance.
For a first time?
Yes, ma'am, for a first time event that was also in combination with another paddling event.
And I had planned to do that, and I had another set that I had to change to. My grandson came down.
Well, I was there.
We brought him.
I was there to watch. And I enjoyed it. It was great.
I know a lot of people who want to do it next year.
Well, and if you guys ever want an individual session, we'll be happy to put together some stand-up paddleboarding and kayaking instruction for you all.
Well, I think we need to make that one of our things.
We'll be happy to do that.
And make sure it's warm water.
Yes, ma'am. We've been having to do it in rain and cooler weather every Friday.
All right, some other events that we have coming up. National Trails Day is happening in Cross State Park. The day after, on June 8th, we're having the Stump Jump Mountain Bike Race. Paddle Fest is happening in Lake Bowen on June 28th. One thing that I'm really excited about, we're having our inaugural season of the Spartanburg Junior Climbing Team. It's going to be starting in September. And last but not least, November 1st, we're going to see if we can't put together what we're calling the Spartanburg County Adventure Race, which will be an off-road triathlon of paddling, mountain biking, and a trail run. And it's the day after Halloween, so costumes will be encouraged.
Costumes will be encouraged, an acronym of SCAR, but don't let it discourage you. it'll be a fun event. But with that being said, we would like to show you the video from Tame the Tiger.
I involved in radio corps.
I was there last year and waiting for the people to cross the finish line and come in, and I'm telling you, it is such a fun day, and you've got families down there. It is just beautiful. But I would have been there this time, but I had a StarTex male reunion that I went to that day, so I apologize for that.
That's okay. Awesome. Thank you all very much for allowing us to present, and I would also like to thank, we're up here representing all of these events, but if it wasn't for our entire department and the teamwork that goes into it, none of this would be possible, so a special thanks to all my coworkers as well.
Thank you. One of the things I will say is that you have only touched on some of the things that you've got planned for this summer. We also know that the summer camps are getting ready to get cranked up again, and we really appreciate what you do for the children in these communities that you offer these summer camps. So thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Very active group. We appreciate that. Thank you. Do we have any questions or any comments? Okay. Mr. Chairman, other than receiving information on the activities of the Parks Department, that's it for our committee today.
Thank you, Ms. Hall. Next, we have Public Safety and Judiciary, Honorable Michael Brand, Chairman. Roger Nutt, Dale Covert, members. Mr. Brown.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. We have three principal items coming before the committee. First, being to receive information and take desired action in reference to a request from the Lake Bowen Baptist Church to sell the world's finest chocolate bars to motorists in the Willow Springs area on Saturday, May 24th, Saturday, May 31st, and Saturday, June 7th, between the hours of 10 a.m. and 2 p.m. at the intersection of Highway 9 and Gold Farms Road, and at the intersection of Highway 9 and Rainbow Lake Road, to raise funds to help send two mission teams on trips this summer to Alaska and Nicaragua. Ms. Denise Ryder is here to present some information.
Good afternoon. That pretty much sums it up. And I apologize, this was my first committee meeting, so I'm a little nervous. So if you have any questions in reference to it, I'll be happy to answer anything I can.
Can they send the group up here first to practice on us to make sure they're qualified?
And we need to set up
some chocolate. See how it's going to taste.
I wish I had thought about that because I have a box at home. I should have brought tea.
We'll work on that.
Mr. Chairman, I motion to approve.
Second. Probably move in second. Let all be known the sign of aye.
Aye.
Thank you.
Thank you.
We'll send us a full council for the approval to request to solicit funds.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Next, committees receive information and take desired action in reference to a victim assistance grant. Mr. Murray Glenn is here, Office Administrator for 7, Judicial Solicitor's Office.
Good afternoon, Chairman, members of council. This is actually a continuation grant for a domestic violence prosecutor. It's a program we've had in place for approximately 8 years, and it's been a huge asset to Spartanburg County. As we've all seen through recent headlines, we need all the help we can get on this front. This grant required only a 25% match, which is already part of our budget. Any questions?
Mr. Chairman, I motion to approve this amendment.
Second. We're probably moving to second. Any discussion? If not, all that is in favor of this, let be known by the sign of aye.
Aye.
Aye. All right.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. And the last item coming before our committee is to receive information in reference to alternative residential housing requirements, and our county administrator will give us some information.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I think, Councilman, that you had talked to the staff about some follow-up to recent meeting you attended and some activity at the General Assembly. Didn't know if you wanted to go through what is going through the General Assembly yourself or whether you want to.
You can go ahead and discuss what's going on in the General Assembly if you'd like.
Sure. It's my idea, it's my understanding that there is a motion going through, I believe, the Senate and the House that would require any type of group housing that would involve convicted sex offenders to be publicly noticed. I'm not sure of the status of that particular bill as it's making its way to the General Assembly. I think the intent is to try to have the public receive some more information about group housing that would involve convicted sex offenders. Is that your understanding?
That's correct.
I think you had wanted to have the staff take a look at this item as well and prepare some options to provide to council where such uses could locate in Spartanburg County. And if that is what the committee would desire, we'll be glad to take a look at that for you and bring back some recommendations to council.
All right, Mr. Chairman, I appreciate you putting this on the agenda. When I went to the Roebuck meeting, I guess a month or so ago, there were a lot of problems, obviously, with the situation that we became aware of, with clustering, I guess, of parolees within a residential area, and there was absolutely no notification that such had occurred. So the two things that I gathered from that meeting, the two major problems, which probably won't solve everything, but I think 90% of the problems were the clustering and the notification. And if we as a council could figure out some type of solution for that, I think we would take a great step in the right direction, not only for those people in Roebuck, but all over the county that can have this problem. We could go ahead and wait to see what happens with the state legislation. However, sometimes it's very slow in getting back to the counties and becoming a law, so we need to take action, I feel, here at a local level and do the right things for our citizens here, and I appreciate you putting this on the agenda.
One question I do have in terms of the potential for other groups that may fall out of this particular classification. Do you know if that's being currently discussed with what's before General Assembly or it's only specifically as relates to this type of alternative policy?
Councilmember, I don't know, but I'd be glad to research that information and make sure that you and the rest of council have that additional detail.
Well, I think that could be a part of this motion. So. With that, any other items or any other discussion with the other council members?
Good. I'd like to make a motion, Mr. Chairman, if I could.
Please.
I'd like to make a motion that the committee direct staff to try to solve these two problems with clustering and notification by preparing options for the council as to where this alternative housing or type of business type can locate in our county.
I'll second the motion. It's been properly moved to second that we are directing staff to review the matters that's coming before this committee, a couple of options as it relates to the alternative housing and their location. Okay. All in favor, let it be known as aye.
Aye.
None opposed. We'll send this to full council for its consideration.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you. That's all the items that come before us, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Mr. Brown. The item is under land use part of the report. Yes, that concludes committee.
Yep. Yes, sir. We're running a little ahead of time.
Yeah, we are. Thank you for your participation.
Mr. Chairman, just as a reminder for council, we do have the Citizens Academy.
Yeah, I'll get ready to bring that up.
Okay.
And so we will adjourn and we will return out front at 5:30. At 5 o'clock, we will have our reception with the graduate of the Spartanburg County Citizens Academy. So that being said, we will adjourn until 5:30. Thank you very much for your attendance. Your attendance earlier today, we had our committee meeting. First item on the agenda to render communication. I'm calling Captain Jerry Clevenger, please. Come forward.
Let us pray. Most gracious Heavenly Father, as we come to you this afternoon, we lift up this precious county to you, Lord, because this county is very precious to those of us who live here. We pray, Father God, for these young lady, Ms. Hall, and these young men who sit, as I say, as you have shown me, in the high place of this county. Father, I pray that you would give them wisdom. I pray, Father God, that you would touch them by your mighty hand. In the Word of God, you teach us about the sons of Issachar, who had an understanding of the times. Many of us don't have an understanding of the times. So we pray that this young lady and young men, along with Miss O'Neill and her staff, Father God, will know the sign of the times, that they will know which way to go. There's decisions to be made, very important decisions to be made. And we pray, Father God, that your wisdom would infuse them to help them, Father God, to make the right decisions for this county, so this county can prosper, so this county can be a county that people will love to come in, that public safety will be at the high, that they will take care of those. We pray, Father God, for those who are of low income, are having difficulty, maybe they're unemployed. We pray, Father God, for them this afternoon, that you would touch them by your mighty hand, that you would help them. Help them, Father God. Help them find a job. Help them to be able to do better, to raise their children in the ways of the Lord. And we'll be very careful, Lord, to give you the praise and the glory. For us, in Jesus' name,
Chaplain, next I've asked Dale Cummings to lead us in the pledge. And to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Item 2, presentations. First, we have a resolution presented by Mr. O'Neill Mintz. Honor and pride to bestow upon Spartanburg County by the achievements of Lauren Kevins with Fallen Springs. Mr. Mintz.
Lauren and her mother, did Robin come in? Robin, guys, did you come on up here? Where's your mother? Mom's not coming. Okay. And Robin is your manager?
Director.
Okay. Well, Robin, we're glad to have you, particularly since you live in my council district. We're really glad to have you here. And it is, if I can say a few words, if you'll, obviously this young lady that's standing beside me is a very attractive young lady. In this resolution, you'll hear that she's won many pageants, and we're going to cross our fingers and hope that in a few months we'll be standing back here again talking to Miss South Carolina. A resolution honoring and recognizing Lauren Kevins for her contribution to the Spartanburg County community, wherein pride and honor have been bestowed upon Spartanburg County by the accomplishments and contributions of Lauren Kevins. Lauren of Bowling Springs, South Carolina, is a graduate of the University of South Carolina with a Bachelor of Arts in Dance Performance, and is the owner and artistic director of Dance Designs in Bowling Springs, South Carolina, where she teaches and coaches aspiring dancers and pageant girls. She is the newly crowned Miss Bowling Springs 2014, placed in the top 5 finalists for Miss South Carolina, and this is an impressive record in 2011, 2012, and 2013, as well as the runner-up to Miss America Organization National Sweetheart Pageant in Houston, Illinois,
Lauren has held numerous other titles, including in the top five fundraisers for the Children's Miracle Network, Miss America Academic Scholar 2013, Miss Hilton Hit Island, Miss Greater Greer, Miss Greater Malden, Miss Mountain Lake USA, as well as Miss Danks of South Carolina 2010 and South Carolina Junior Miss in 2009. She will compete for Miss South Carolina this summer in Columbia, South Carolina, and hopes to bring home the crown to the upstate. And we hope that for you also, because I certainly think you have the looks for that young lady. Lauren is presently traveling the upstate to promote her platform of motivation of at-risk youth through science, technology, interpreted through engineering and the arts, all based in mathematical elements. Education in partnership with the Boys and Girls Club of America, and continues to promote this platform in the community. Now therefore, be it resolved that Spartanburg County Council does hereby recognize Lauren Kevins for her accomplishments and contributions to Spartanburg County. Be it further resolved that this resolution be presented to Lauren Kevins in recognition thereof and be made a part of the permanent minutes of Spartanburg County Council. Adopted this 19th day of May 2014. This is signed by Spartanburg County Council Chairman Jeffrey Horton and Catherine L. O'Neill, County Administrator. Mr. Chairman, I move to adopt.
Now, motion to accept. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? I'll vote affirmative, and it passes. Mr. Judge Vance. He's already won.
And we're going to give you a
I'm a little shorter, unfortunately. I first want to thank you all for no one opposing that. I do appreciate that. I'm very excited to be here today. I'm a proud resident of Spartanburg County and have been since the age of five. I'm a Dorman graduate, so go Cavaliers, yes. Like he said, I graduated from the University of South Carolina, but I'm actually a diehard Clemson fan. So if you want to know how that works out, just ask me at a different time, but it is possible. I stay loyal to the Tigers, although my degree is from Carolina. But I so enjoyed being a part of this community, not just as a resident over my life, but now as a business owner in Bowling Springs. Like he said, I had my own dance studio where I coach not only aspiring dancers, but also pageant contestants and do a lot of choreography. And it's exciting to be a part of such a growing community as a business center. And so I'm excited to represent this area in the Miss South Carolina competition. I've come close several times, so I'm hoping to seal the deal this year and finally make that happen and really bring a lot of spotlight and press to this area and even more notably the Bowling Springs area. So thank you so much, and I appreciate all of your time, and fingers crossed for the Miss South Carolina competition, which is June 24th through 28th, and it will be airing live on TV on Fox affiliate networks as well. So you can tune in and watch that and keep your fingers crossed, and I appreciate that. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Principal back down too, Mr. Tommy Zell. Tom, can you make your way on down here?
Johnny, I'll say you have the chairman in his hand, so you get some pictures so Mr. Vance can get up to them. Thank you, sir.
Alec was down here just a few short months ago when the Chesty and Cheer Squad won the state competition. And I embarrassed myself because I overlooked him. But all those good-looking girls you had with you, that had something to do with it. This young man has done something that we're not sure that has anybody from Spartanburg County has accomplished before. We can't find any record of it. He is the South Carolina High School Cheerleader of the Year. He attends Chesney High School, which is a 2A school, but this includes all schools. It's a major, major accomplishment in his short career, because I've got a cheerleader that Alex cheered with last year for 2 years that's on scholarship at Clemson, Clemson cheerleader. And I've got another one that he cheers with that's going to graduate next year. And these girls have been in cheering since they were 6 years old, and Alex has done this since for the last 3 years. So it's a major accomplishment you've done. We're very proud of you in the Chesney area. A resolution expressing recognition and appreciation for the pride and honor bestowed upon Spartanburg County and the Chesney Eagles by the achievements of Alex DeLeon and being named the South Carolina High School Cheerleader of the Year, whereas pride and honor have been bestowed upon Spartanburg County and the Chesney Eagles by Alex DeLeon being named the South Carolina High School Cheerleader of the Year. Alex is the first male to ever receive this honor. Alex has been a member of the Eagles cheer squad for the past 3 years, which he admits was one of the best moves of his life. He states that cheering is the best sport in the world. It's something I love. Allie Tyman, coach of the Eagles cheer squad, states, "He is one of the best cheerleaders, male or female, that I have ever seen." It's a major statement, Alex. Alex intends to continue his career at the next level by looking to cheer in college. Alex, by his achievements, has opened the door for other boys who want to cheer. Now, therefore, be it resolved that Spartanburg County Council does hereby recognize Alex DeLeon for his achievements in cheerleading competition and be named the South Carolina High School Cheerleader of the Year. Be it further resolved that a copy of this resolution be presented to Alex DeLeon in recognition thereof and be made a part of the permanent minutes of Spartanburg County Council adopted this 19th day of May 2014. This is signed by Spartanburg County Council Chairman Ray Horton and Catherine L. O'Neill County Administrator. Mr. Chairman, I move to adopt.
I have a motion. Second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? Affirmative? And passed. Mr. Mayor.
Congratulations, young man. Great job.
Go Eagles.
Citizens and save countless lives by providing reasonable safeguards to protect us from dangerous situations and by addressing other issues such as energy efficiency, water conservation, and sustainability. Whereas building safety and fire social officials, architects, engineers, builders, and others in the construction industry work with the public to address building safety concerns, including safeguards to minimize the impact of natural disasters such as ice and snowstorms, hurricanes, tornadoes, wildland fires, earthquakes, and playing a vital role in ensuring the safety of our critical infrastructure. And whereas the annual observance of the Building Safety Month calls attention to the life safety services provided by the local and state building departments and by the federal agencies. And whereas by this theme of building safety, maximizing resilience, minimizing risk, the 2014 observance of the Building Safety Month encourages all Americans to raise awareness for the importance of safe, resilient building, fire prevention, disaster mitigation, backyard safety, energy efficiency, and new technologies in the construction industry. Now therefore it be resolved that Spartanburg County Council does hereby proclaim May 2014 as the Building Safety Month in Spartanburg County. Adopted this 19th day of May 2014, signed by Jeffrey A. Hort, Chairman, and attested by Catherine L. O'Neill, Administrator.
Jerry?
So, Chairman, move to adopt this resolution.
Second. Motion and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? I vote affirmative. It passes. Thank you, Jerry. Thank you for having me.
What a great time to be in Spartanburg County, and so many people want to develop in our county. And so Building Safety Month comes at a good time this year. So we certainly will be preparing ourselves for our new friends that's coming. And I'll take this back to the coach employees. They certainly appreciate it. Thank you again.
Jerry. I just want to say a quick word, Jerry. I had the pleasure and was a privilege actually to watch Jerry in action. About a month ago, we visited one of our newest announcements, and the way Jerry handled himself with professionalism in front of this big group just had such a can-do attitude. I've used that once today, but it really defines you and your team. But it was just, it was an honor, you know, just to work with you on that day and all that you've done since then. I know, you know, you and your team do a great job, and that's why we have Toray, BMW, Basco, and all these other companies announcing here. Because y'all all partnership, you know, we established. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Appreciate you.
Thank you, Jerry.
Next we have item D, recognition of our graduates of the academy. Apparently we didn't have any hard names tonight. It didn't come up before the meeting. Goddamn. Oh, yeah, Dickie Adams. This is our 14th class. And these people have taken time out of their busy schedule to learn more about Spartanburg County, to learn more about the Jones. Ingrid Blue. Becky Bray. Ronnie Bray. A little earlier, he emerged at the cantaloupe. Kathy Fullamore. Johnny, you make all those pictures look good for them now. You take me out of it, I'm running out. Ruben McKissick. Right.
How you doing? Lock them out. Call that Robertson. Lynn Turner, down here. Oh, you're going to sit up for that?
No.
You can, don't you? Feel a lot perfect. Take a second, right?
Thank you.
You want help? Yeah. All right, thank you. And again, thank you for taking your time to learn more about county government. I had a lot of people, again, comment that they learned a lot about county government. So again, we've turned out another class of candidates for board appointments and hopefully other functions related to county government. And Kathy and your team, where are you? Where are you? Where's Kathy? Stand up, Kathy. Come on. And Kathy, we thank you for your dedication and hard work. You make the county look good. Thank you. We go to free employee recognition, Catherine O'Neill.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman and members of council. I have several folks I'd like to recognize today. Todd Stevens, I see you sitting way there in the back. You always try to go without being noticed, but today I'm here to recognize you and your team. As council knows, we have done trying to move forward with technology, but a lot of our records are still kept in a microfilm state, and our machines haven't really been what we had wanted them to be. I made a quick call to Todd when we were looking for some microfilm machines, and he goes, said to me, well, Catherine, you know, we may have a couple that we can share with you that we'll be rotating out. And that turned into quite a donation from the library, Todd, and I'm here to say thank you, and I think council is as well. If you'll be recognized for this. The Spartanburg County Library donated 8 microfilm machines and 4 printers to us, and that is a huge, huge, huge thank you from us. So Todd, thanks for being there when I called. You never hesitated, you made it all happen. Thank you so much. I saw you come in, would you join me here? I think we've had some folks on your team have been recently recognized. Would you tell us a little bit more about the outstanding SC Work Center Award?
There are 12 workforce boards in the state of South Carolina, and I would venture to say probably about 46 SC Work Centers. And the workforce boards, we fund the SC Work Center. And this past year, we once again won the SC Work Center of the Year from the State Workforce Investment Board. And with me, I have Brenda Connolly. She is our liaison to the SC Work Center here from our office to provide technical support, monitor them, make sure they're spending their money correctly and doing what they're supposed to do. And Johnny Lynn is the new director of SC Works and does a fantastic job. So I really appreciate what they do and what everyone does in the office and with SC Works.
Thank you.
world. So Ian and Johnny Lynn and Brenda, thank you guys so much. Also wanted to recognize Jessica with our IT department. Hey, Jess.
Hey.
Another one of our heroes that tries to remain in the background, but I'm here to congratulate her today on behalf of the county. Jess has received her certification as an on-base administrator. And council, if you'll join me in recognizing her, that's a big deal as we move forward with document management. This was a big achievement for you. Didn't come easy, and we're so proud of you. So congratulations.
Thank you.
I don't know if you had the opportunity to catch an article in the stroller here recently, but I'd like to share with you some folks on our team that were recognized here recently in the Herald Journal. Jerry Glover, you just were recognized, but if you'll stand, Richard Cash from the Assessor's Office, Dorothy Earle, she's our Register of Deeds, Sharon West, I think, is Sharon able to join us? Hey, Sharon. And as a group, our sheriff's deputy, so Neil, I think you're going to represent everybody, the sheriff's department. So Ed Sloan wrote the stroller. His comment had, let's be fair about government workers. He says, Spartanburg County government is blessed with an unusual cadre of responsive, professional, and knowledgeable employees. They help make Spartanburg County the great place that it is. And he went on to recognize each of these individuals specifically and council. It goes without saying, but I'm going to say it. These really are our team leaders and ambassadors. And if you'll join me in thanking them once again for making the county look incredible. So Mike Emery and Terry Sock, everybody who's being recognized is right behind this camera. I'm sorry. Mike Emery and Terry Sock, it's okay.
Thank you. Thank you.
We had an opportunity, shall we say, Mike, here recently. You know the real test of a true leader is when you step up when nobody asks you to do so. Mike, I'm here to say thank you. We had a rather rainy spring, and we've had some transition with our landscaping team and our county courthouse. Kind of looked a little unkept. And Mike and Terry actually came in early one day on their own, took care of the grass and making our building look incredible. And I'm here to say thank you. I know we're transitioning to a new vendor. You guys picked up here and did something that I don't know that maybe all of our managers really would, but I know you did. And I really appreciate that. Thank you, Mike. And please extend our thank you to Terry as well. And then, Council, I have a letter to read about our park staff. And I know that a number of you guys, I guess, are still here under our parks. Yes, hey, Jim, where's the rest of your team? Team, stand up. I wanted to, I'm assuming that we have here Dennis. I saw Dennis, Trey, and Chad. Okay. Wanted to share with you some incredible feedback that we got. It was from Kara Gillespie. She wrote, as a Duncan resident, District 5 teacher, and mother of two active boys, I wanted to take a moment and let you know how much I appreciate Tiger River Park. Your department's willingness to better our community by creating and supporting Tiger River Park is something to be proud of. I'm very grateful to live in a community that realizes the importance of this type of outdoor recreation. My children are very lucky to have such nice facilities in which to play baseball. The fields, stands, parking, and restrooms are very well taken care of. The workers are also helpful and friendly to the young players. These accommodations are far superior than anything we had years ago. I'm sure you've received complaints since the park's opening, as it is common when working with the public. I want to remind you that for the one or two negative comments you may hear, there are tons of more positive remarks that unfortunately go unheard. Today, hers is being heard. Again, thanks for what your group is doing to add value to our community, Kara Gillespie. You guys, this it's compliment after compliment. I'm so proud of what you're doing in Tiger River and across the county. Thank you so much for making our county look so good. Mr. Chairman, that's all I have. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. O'Neill. Yeah, but I just want to add a statement about Tiger River Park. I live in that area. This is in my district. But I walk the Tiger River Park every day with my dog. And this past weekend, they were having tournaments, as they always do on the weekends. And this lady came up to me, and of course, the conversation started about the dog. But it ended up being about how wonderful it is to have a park like this in Spartanburg. And she was from Asheville, North Carolina. And she said, we travel all over playing these tournament plays, but there is no park that compares to Tiger River. And that was just from someone who was visiting. So thank you so much for all you do. I can honestly say that at 7:30 and 8 o'clock in the mornings, I see them out working the fields and getting the diamonds ready. And I see them also late at night. So you do have a dedicated staff. I recognize that, as does this council. We thank you for it.
Thank you. Right, next we move to item 4 and conduct our public hearings. I open item 8, consider a budget ordinance related to the fiscal affairs of Spartanburg County, the levy and taxes for the fiscal year beginning July 1st, 2014, and then June 30, 2015. Anyone here tonight want to speak regarding the county's budget? We're giving second reading tonight. Unseen closed item 8. Open item B to consider budget ordinance to establish our capital projects budget for 2014-2015 as a 5-year capital improvement plan. Anyone speak on the capital improvement plan budget? None seen. Closed B and open C to determine whether and to what extent the service area of this Spartanburg Sanitary Sewer District shall be enlarged. Anyone speak on behalf of this public hearing? None seen. Closed C. Open item D to consider an application for a special public event exclusion from the Lord Governor requested by Monterey from 12 p.m. to 11:59 p.m. on Saturday, June 7th for 2014 for a benefit at the Spartanburg Moose Lodge, 150 Pioneer Fish Camp Road, Roebuck. Anyone speak on behalf of this public hearing? None seen. Closed D. Open E to consider an application for special public event exclusion from the Lord Governor requested by Samantha Sun from 4 p.m. until 11:59 on Saturday, May 24th, 2014 for a Cambodian baby shower party at 3890 Capitol Ridge Road, Campbell Valley. Anyone speak on behalf of public hearing? None seen. Closed E. Open F to consider an application for special public event exclusion from the noise ordinance requested by Johnny Sinchaxi of the Loud Association of Spartanburg from 11 a.m. to 11:59 on Saturday, May 24th, 2014, and 11:59 a.m. to 11 p.m. on Sunday, May 25th, 2014, for a Memorial Day celebration at 470 Fox Drive. Anyone speak on behalf of this public hearing? Unseen. Close F. Open G to consider an application for a special public event exclusion from the North Orchard requested by Grand Dragway from 4 p.m. until midnight on Saturday, June 7, 2014, and Saturday, June 21, 2014, for a drag race at 1792 Dragway Road Career. Anyone speak on behalf of the public hearing? Unseen. Close G. That concludes public hearings. Earlier today, we had our committee meetings, and at this time, we'll start with our Economic Recruitment and Development, Honorable David Britt, Chairman. Mr. Britt.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. We have two items the committee would like to report on. The first is request under first reading to an ordinance to amend an existing agreement for the development of a joint county industrial business park by and between Spartanburg County and Union County, South Carolina, so as to enlarge the boundaries of the park to include certain properties located in Spartanburg County, presently owned by Michelin North America Inc. Move for approval, first reading.
Second. Have a motion and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, vote affirmative, it is passed.
Second item, committee recommends full council to render first reading to an ordinance to amend the agreement for development for a joint county industrial park bound between Spartanburg County and Cherokee County, South Carolina, so as to include additional property in Spartanburg County as part of the joint county industrial park. Mr. Chairman, I move that we approve on first reading.
We have a motion.
Second.
And a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, vote affirmative, it passes.
Concludes our committee report.
Thank you, Mr. Brett. We need another $1 billion announcement. It's been a month. Come on, tell us business. No items under public health. Next, we have personnel now and finance. Honorable Dale Cover, Chairman. Mr. Cover.
Chairman, we have several items on our committee today. Our first was receive information and take desired action in reference to the Accommodation Tax Advisory Committee recommendations for fiscal year 2015. We tabled that until next month. But the second item was to receive information and take desired action in reference to a budget ordinance related to the fiscal affairs of Spartanburg County, making appropriations, therefore, levying taxes for the fiscal year beginning July 1st, 2014 and ending June 30th, 2015. Provide for the budget control and said appropriation by Spartanburg County. We have two amendments to this that we want to have here and the committee brings to us. The first is the general fund operating budget motion. On behalf of the committee, I move that the amended part one of the budget ordinance operations Spartanburg County Government Section 8 appropriation as follows. Amend the general fund expenditures by increasing the appropriation to the Emergency Services Academy Department by $35,000. To $227,021 and decreasing the appropriation to the transfers between funds from the department by $35,000 to $15,502,690. Mr. Chairman, I move that we approve.
We have a motion on this First Amendment.
Second.
Second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, I vote affirmative, it passes.
Second Amendment. This is the main session of the SADAC Fund Operating Budget Motion. On behalf of the committee, I move that we amend Part 1 of the Budget Ordinance Operations of Spartanburg County Government, Section 8, Appropriations Related to the Alcohol and Drug Abuse Fund, SADAC, to increase the fund balance to the alcohol and drug abuse line items and to increase the following departments, Community Referral, Prevention, Drug Court by the amount shown in the table below, and to increase the authorized staffing by one slot, a 0.67 FTES for the part-time position related to a new grant and to change the total alcohol and drug abuse fund revenue and expenditure appropriations to $3,110,085. The total revenue and expenditure appropriation for all funds will change to $177,438,496. Mr. Chairman, I so move.
Have a motion on this amendment. We have a second. Second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, vote affirmative, and it passes.
Mr. Chairman, the committee also recommends that after we've rendered these first readings, that we render second reading to the budget.
We have a motion on the second reading of the budget. So we have a second.
Second.
And a second. Any other discussion on the budget? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, vote affirmative, and it passes.
Next item on our agenda was to receive and take desired action in reference to a budget ordinance to establish the capital budgets for the year 2014 through 2015 budget year of the five-year capital improvement plan. Mr. Chairman, we have amendment to this motion also. The capital budget motion removal of the fundraising of the ESC burn building repairs. On behalf of the committee, I move that amended part one, section one of the capital budget ordinance for fiscal year 2014 through 2015 as related to the general fund transfer and public safety project expenditures. This amendment will decrease the transfer from the general fund by $35,000 from $435,000 to $400,000 and decrease the public safety appropriation by $35,000 from $2,056,371 to $2,021,371, thereby decreasing the total capital budget from $19,149,620 to $19,114,620. Mr. Chairman, I move for this amendment.
We have a motion on this amendment to the capital, five-year capital plan.
Second.
And a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, no vote affirmative, it passes.
Mr. Chairman, and the committee recommends that we render second reading to the ordinance, and I so move.
Second reading to the five-year capital plan, equipment plan for 2014-15. Do we have a second?
Second.
And a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, no vote affirmative, it passes.
The last item on our agenda is to receive information and take desired action in reference to a resolution of historic designation for a special past district assessment under section 70-169 of the Spartanburg County, South Carolina Code of Ordinances for by certain parcel of improved real property known as the Appalachian Mill. Mr. Chairman, I'd like to recommend to the full committee that we adopt this resolution.
We have a motion.
I move.
Second. And a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, no vote affirmative, it passes. Okay, Mr. Coburn.
Please, our meeting, sir.
All right. Thank you, Mr. Coburn. Next, we have Livability Committee, Honorable Jane Hall, Chairman. Ms. Hall.
Yes, Mr. Chairman. We received information today in reference to the Tame the Tiger race that took place this spring. It was very successful with 148 participants on the river and 96 competitors during this race. We also received information on the activities of the Parks Department, and that concludes our committee.
Thank you, Ms. Holly. Next, we have Public Safety and Judiciary, Honorable Michael Brown, Chairman. Mr. Brown.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. We had three principal items come before the committee. The first of which we received information for the desired action in reference to a request from Lake Moyne Baptist Church to sell the world's finest chocolate bars to motorists in the Boyle Springs area on Saturday, May 24th, Saturday, May 31st, and Saturday, June 7th, between the hours of 10 a.m. and 2 p.m. at the intersection of Highway 9 and Old Furnace Road, and at the intersection of Highway 9 and the Rainbow Lake Road, to raise funds to help send two missions on trips this summer to Alaska and New Orleans. On behalf of the committee, Mr. Chairman, I make a motion that we approve the request to solicit funds.
I have a motion and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? Vote affirmative, it passes.
Next, we received information for desired action in reference to a victim assistance grant. Based upon the recommendation of the committee, Mr. Chairman, I make a motion that we approve the submittal of the grant.
I have a motion and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? Vote affirmative, it passes.
The third item, Mr. Chairman, we received information in reference to an alternative residential housing requirements as by way of discussion and the direct recommendation of the committee. I make a motion that we move to direct our staff to review matters relating to alternative residential housing requirements and to prepare options as to where such uses can be located in the county.
Second. We have a motion and a second. Any other discussion?
Got a quick question. This is really for, I guess, our administration staff. Do we have any tools in place or that we can put in place that would prevent any of these from getting, you know, established until you all come back with your recommendations?
Councilmember, I think it would be difficult to have any restrictions that you could put into place now while you're going through the process of investigating your options. I understand your concerns. I think that any action you can take here may be premature based on what options you may be provided.
And you have a discussion.
I'm going to have a statement. I know this is in your district, Roger, and I'd like to thank you for stepping up and for the work you've done with this.
Thank you, Councilman. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, vote affirmative, it passes.
Mr. Chairman, those are all the items that came before our committee today.
Thank you, Mr. Brown. No items under land use today are public works. David, do we have anyone sign up? No?
All right, now we move to item seven, old business, render third reading to an ordinance authorizing the execution and delivery of amendment to a fee agreement between Spartanburg County and Michigan, North America.
Under approval, third reading.
We have a motion and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, vote affirmative, it passes. Item B, render third reading to an ordinance authorizing the Woodruff Grove Water District to enlarge its service area and reapportion its voting areas.
Mr. Chairman, I move that we have a third reading on this motion.
Have a motion.
Second.
And a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, vote affirmative, it passes. Item C, render second reading to an ordinance authorizing the execution and delivery of a fee in lieu agreement between Project McDonald's and Spartanburg County.
Move approval, second reading.
Second. Have a motion and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, vote affirmative, it passes. Item D, render second reading to an ordinance authorizing the Spartanburg County, Spartanburg Sanitary Sewer District to enlarge its service area.
So moved.
Second.
Have a motion and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, vote affirmative, and it passes. Item E, render second reading to an ordinance to provide for the adjustment of certain fees by resolution of county council.
Move approval, second reading.
Second. Have a motion and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, vote affirmative, and it passes. Item F, render second reading to an ordinance to amend the Unified Land Management Ordinance to provide for certain fees by resolution of county council.
So moved.
Second. Motion and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, vote affirmative, passes. Move to item eight, new business. Receive information, take desired action in reference to a resolution authorizing the delinquent tax collector of Spartanburg to transfer property to the Spartanburg County Forfeited Land Commission.
Move we adopt the resolution.
Have a motion.
Second.
And a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, vote affirmative, and it passes. Item B, consider an application for a special public event exclusion from the noise ordinance requested by Mark Moray from 12:01 p.m. to 11:59 p.m. on Saturday, June 7th for a benefit at the Spartanburg Moose Lodge, 155 near Fiscount Road. Have a motion.
So moved.
Do we have a second?
Second.
Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, vote affirmative, passes. Consider an application for a special public event exclusion from the noise ordinance requested by Samantha Song from 4 p.m. to 11:59 on Saturday, May 24, 2014 for a Cambodian baby shower party at 3890 County Road, Tampa Bay.
So moved.
Have a motion and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, vote affirmative. Item D, consider an application for a special public event exclusion from the noise ordinance requested by Johnny from the Loud Association of Spartanburg from 11 a.m. to 11:59 p.m. on Saturday, May 24, 2014, and 11:59 a.m. until 11 p.m. on Sunday, May 25, 2014, at Memorial Day Celebration at 470 Fox Drive.
So moved.
We have a motion and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, vote affirmative, and it passes. Item E, consider an application for a special public event exclusion from the noise ordinance requested by Greer Dragway from 4 p.m. to midnight on Saturday, June 7, 2014, and Saturday, June 21, 2014, for a drag race at 1792 Dragway Road, Greer.
Motion to approve.
Second. Have a motion and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. Opposed, vote affirmative, it passes. Catherine, anything under nine we need to address?
Yes, sir.
On 10, we need a motion for the budget amendment resolution.
So moved.
Have a motion. Second. Any other discussion?
Mr. Chairman, if I may, I just wanted to point out and provide a quick thank you to Confluence Outdoor. As part of your budget amendment resolutions, they donated kayak paddles, canoe paddles, and other outdoor recreation equipment towards a number of initiatives that we talked about. Donations valued at approximately $3,000, so we really wanted to say a thank you to them for making that donation.
And who was that again?
Confluence Outdoor.
Okay, thank you to them. We had a motion and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, vote affirmative, it passes. Need approval of the minutes of April 21, 2014, and May 2, 2014.
So moved.
A motion, and a second.
Second.
Any other discussion? All in favor, all opposed, affirmative. Remind everyone that Wednesday we will have a visionary retreat. Need a motion to return, from the adjourn, and return, hopefully. Have a motion and a second. All in favor, say aye this time.
Aye.
Thank you for being here today, Tom.